Hi everyone, my name is Asat and welcome back to my 1962 walkthrough. Sorry about that, I finished it early, but I was too tired to continue. But this time it's morning. It can be happen. Of
stop doing that.
Thank you.
the game.
You are quiet. What do you think of this place?
I think we should empty it. The only good Morden city is a cemetery.
Your thoughts are mine. A world without Morden is my ultimate desire.
Sounds good. I'll stand with you, Fenalla.
That is good to hear, so long as you do not stand too close.
Funny.
Thank you. can barely speak of the torment from those foul creatures. They tricked me into joining their army, but when I refused to kill one of my own kind, they set a pack of gnaw beasts on me. For the honor of all the victims who have fallen in their paths, they must die. Justice must be served.
I have my whole score to sell away the modern. Trust me, the betrayer on the troop will not go unpunished.
I am in your debt. I will wait for them on this side of the veil.
War. knew it.
For hundreds of years, my family's ancestors have lived in the ancient city of Galrathia. Until my wife, my children, my lineage were all exterminated in a matter of minutes by the blade of a Morden raider. A horror I was forced to watch before I, too, fell beneath his cold steel. My soul will not rest until the Morden are punished for their crimes against my family.
I have also lost friends and comrades in the to Morden cruelty. You have my word. I will rid the land of their savagery.
Thank you, kind traveler. I sense a conviction in your words that tells me you will succeed where others have failed. This gives me peace.
Yes, now I know that your family will be with me. One underneath Carapia and one in Zaramos.
Welcome to Derek's Magic Emporium, where
The secret entrance to their bug hatchery is near here. If we destroy it, we take out one of their weapons. Aha! Here we are.
Those bugs are disgusting! Let's go!
Bugs.
Thank you.
used on elevated gears. This is sure to be useful somewhere.
That's not surprising. The Morden left for an engineer like you now.
They are the ones who will be surprised when I wipe each last one of them from existence.
You could do it. That would not surprise me either.
If it had not been for you, I would still be in Amonlu wondering what to do. It is good to know I am of service to my people in this war.
It seems that nothing escapes your notice, Fenala. I am glad.
I've also noticed the sour looks you've been giving me when you thought my back was turned. Are you still glad?
Fuck. No, not like that, idiot! Not like that! Don't you know that?
Greetings.
Hello.
I am Nordax, and this is Nylion. Lovely day.
Yes, but you are Morden, aren't you? Why are you behaving so civilized?
Why not? Have you done something that should upset us?
Well, up until now, I have mercilessly slain all Morden I have ever met.
Ah, well, some things can't be helped, can they? Besides, I'm certain they quite deserved it. Indeed. If the manner in which our own people have treated us is any example, then they got what was coming to them. Nordax and I have had enough and are abandoning this vast for greener pastures. Besides, all this sand and heat makes me itch. Any recommendations? What did you say your name was again?
I didn't. This is... He's all rather confused, but I should just slay you both now and be done.
Good heavens, no. Hear me out, please. It all started when Baldus decided he simply had to have some silly relic. A broken fragment of metal, of all things. Anyhow, our company was ordered to lay siege to some human castle. Snowbrook Haven, I believe it was. Quite. Nyliok and I were in charge of the Clask pets. We are tamers, you know, and Clasks are used to break through the fortress gates. Well, Clask cannot keep up with a cow beast at full gallop. Quite reasonably, Nyliok decided the thing to do was to take a shortcut. I thought it was a good idea at the time. Anyway, before we left, we got directions from the Morden scribe. He said to head east to the fallen bridge, but it should have been west. Really, the old fool needs to update his maps in a bad way. And then we were to go 13 leagues southeast when it should have been 31. So how long do you suppose it took us to reach the castle? 2 weeks, was it? Fantastic architecture that place has. Have you ever been there?
I was there doing this.
What did you make of those flying buttresses? It must have taken years to build them. Those humans are exceptional engineers. And that scroll work around the throne room. What a perfect example of Neo-Asianite revivalism. It's really too bad so much of the place has had to be smashed. These class can be rather enthusiastic at times. Quiet, Bruno! Neo-Asianite revivalism? Are you mad? That was much too squared off. Everybody knows the Asianite style featured graceful curves and rounded molding. Mad, am I? That rounded molding went out of style during the Varadskian era, which was long before those short-lived humans could possibly have constructed such a place. Ah, point taken. Well, it was a very nice castle anyways.
Oh, I agree.
If excuse me, but would you two please get to the point?
The point? Oh, dreadfully sorry. Well, we didn't reach the haven until well after the siege had ended. And all the Clask save for Bruno here perished in the mountain snows. They're not very bright, I'm afraid. Bruno. Well, our own leaders wanted to execute us for our failure. We departed from there hastily, as you could well imagine. No great loss, really. We didn't agree with this whole war thing anyway.
That's an odd viewpoint, especially for Mort.
Oh, we're not the only ones. But more importantly, if we return to Darth Rule proper, we'll certainly be executed on sight. We've decided we need a vacation. A nice holiday. Yes, the only thing standing in our way is that we don't have nearly enough supplies. Had to leave town in somewhat of a rush. We were wondering, since you know the area, would you mind going back and locating a few supplies for us?
This is highly unusual, but I cannot help being intrigued. I should see what I can do.
Splendid! Now then, here is the key to the Darth Rule supply rooms. There are three, but the key will open all the doors. See if you can find a Morden tent and some Morden rations. Oh, and a pack of Clask rations for Bruno here.
Quiet, Bruno. Very well, Nordas. I'm on my way.
Thank you.
Let's get him.
All right.
Steve, let's throw Steve. We need a plan. How about boiling oil? We could pour the boiling oil on him.
Sounds like too much stuff.
It sounds like fun to me.
What? How did you get in here?
I come to ask you to have mercy on the townspeople that are dying. You must let them have their water.
That is to be expected during a time of war, maggot. Their lives are of little consequence.
Our life is important.
You must be the mangy cur who killed my Ganth! I raised you from a pup! You have signed your death warrant, fool!
I think not. There will indeed be a death warrant signed in your own blood.
Fucker!
Child Lord. You have done your part. Now it is his turn. He must rise to your challenge.
What challenge is that?
You have killed the Morden chief, but others will surely come. The villagers can either sit back and wait for their new captors, or they can stand in defiance. The moment of decision is now.
We will see what happens.
Aye.
It deserved it, mother. Never defeat.
Excellent. Now we have everything we need to begin our journey. We've heard of an isle with plenty of palm trees, white sand beaches, and lovely ladies. What was it called again? Redland? Redland? No, Raylan. Although, didn't we launch a vicious attack there recently? Perhaps we should reconsider. True. Say, what about that quaint ebb place? I've always wanted to see Glacern and Dragon's Wrath and...
So, is there anything else you to need?
How rude of me! I almost forgot! Thank you for your kind help. We don't have anything to spare, but just over this wall there's an ancient vault that might contain something interesting for an adventurous type like you. Bruno, make yourself useful and knock down that wall for our nice friend here.
time for a bell.
You have returned.
Yes, and I bring good news. Here is the head of Morden Chief. Relieve him.
No!
Why so upset? He was not using it anyway. On the advisor kind of not happy about it.
Their chief is gone. They won't have another for at least a day. The advantage is ours. We must strike now.
Think what you are saying, fool! Once you raise arms against the Morden, death is inevitable. My lord, we may be able to repair this situation before it is too late. We must go to the Morden, throw ourselves on their mercy, tell them that this stranger does not speak for us.
Idiot.
This one does speak for us, and all those who hate the Morden occupation.
Kynos, you must choose courage over prudence. Tharuth has a plan.
We have been stockpiling supplies for months and honing our skills in secret. We will don our armor and fall on the filthy curs all at once. They are complacent and will not expect a surprise attack from all directions. We are ready. You need only give the word, my liege.
You fool! Valdis and his Morden have not conquered half the land by chance. Do you really think he is unaware of your preparations? He and his dark wizards can see all. Your rebellion will be over before it can begin. Have you so quickly forgotten the reports we received from Amon-Lu?
I am not asking your permission, Kynos. The time is now. We must strike.
Tharuth is right. And, if you will, we need your help one more time if this rebellion has any hope of succeeding. Speak with Tharuth to get started. Help us clear the town of Morden.
I leave to rouse the town. Follow me, and we shall spill some Morden blood tonight. It has begun.
Morden in victory.
Well done.
Thank you.
You could be a leader of men.
That is not the role I desire.
That is a shame. I would follow you into any battle.
I suspect you for anyone.
Yes, but that is beside the point.
Thank you.
Morden have fallen back before us.
But for how long? More will come. Do you realize what you've done?
Yes.
I know what we did not do. We did not lay down and die like dogs. We stood and we fought like men. Free men.
And now I must leave. I cannot rest until I find it.
This thing you seek, have you seen it before?
I am carrying two with me now. I will not rest until I bring all of them together.
Those artifacts repel those who try to acquire them for selfish reasons. Your heart must be pure, and so I will give this to you.
Sire!
Shut up, fucker!
The Aegis of Sight, it is yours, as it was meant to be.
I hope that you had it.
Now you need only find the fourth piece, but I must warn you, the Dark Wizards possess it now.
How do you know these things?
I do not tell you everything, Kynos.
Why do the Dark Wizards have it?
I suspect it is to keep it from you, my friend.
I must find them now.
Then you must travel to the Mines of Cataract, beyond the Morden city of Darthrul. The entrance is protected by a cluster of magical statues. You have to destroy them if you are to enter.
And, if you're going to reach them, you will need this. I took it from one of the Morden, right after I tore out his heart. I'm not sure where it goes exactly, but it seems likely to be linked to a teleporter within the Morden's territory.
Thank you. I will do one with
it. It was good fortune that brought you to us. We will forever be in your debt.
You are a fool to think that this will turn out well.
It will turn out well. I will make sure of it. Farewell.
Our job is not yet done, Daru.
A pint would do us no harm. This trek has been arduous. Can we not enjoy this moment of victory?
I enjoy a pint as much as the next one. There will be time enough to celebrate when Valdis is dead.
Valdis, I tire of the sound of his name.
You'll be saluting that name every hour if he prevails.
Never!
Then fight, girl. Save your drinking for another day.
I must stop now. Okay. I did Okay, the guys, that's all for now. Bye-bye.